Welcome back, everybody. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. In today's video, I will be going over my full Fortnite account, and we're going to be talking about this season and what I thought and what I hope for next season. I do have a major announcement. I will not be streaming on YouTube anymore, so if you guys would like to see me stream, and by the way, I did get a face cam, so there will be face cam streams if you guys would like to see those. Make sure to head into the link in the description, go to my Twitch and drop me a follow. As this video goes up, I will be streaming, so make sure to go check me out there, guys. Next season, I will be grinding out Fortnite all the levels all day long, so make sure to check me out on Twitch, guys. And by the way, if you did want to see my punch card and how far I got into completing it, make sure to go check the video in the link in the description, because I did go over my full punch card and how much I completed it. To be honest, it wasn't all that much. I definitely thought I was going to get more, but there really wasn't a point in grinding this season. So now it's time to start going over every single skin I own. And if you guys haven't seen one of these videos in a while, there's no way I can talk about every single skin in this game. There are way too many skins. If I went through and talked about every single one of them, this video would be about 10 hours long. So I have to just sit here and scroll through them and you guys can just check them out. I will be talking about certain skins this season, because I think, you know, some of them are worth talking about, like the Galaxy Scout here. You guys are gonna have to tell me what you think about this skin. Overall, I think it's pretty solid. I think it's just as good as the Galaxy, maybe a tiny bit worse, but still in that same ballpark area of being pretty good for a pretty basic skin, in my opinion. But the first thing I did want to talk about in today's video is whether I like this season or not, what I thought about it, and whether I thought it was a little bit too long. I would say at this point, Epic Games definitely has to decrease the amount of time per season. We aren't getting as many new items. We aren't getting as many new weapons. There's just nothing new. Back in the day, we would get a new location here or there, maybe once a month, but hey, that would suffice. This season, yes, we did get a new location, but there wasn't much hype around it, and I feel like not many people really cared, including myself. And with the lack of updates, the lack of patch notes, I feel like Epic Games has to shorten the seasons by a dramatic amount of time. Each season from now on should be a month shorter at the very least. I really can't stand these seasons that last 3 months. It's too long. And even though this season didn't last 3 months unless it's delayed, I still feel like this 70-day season is way too long. Especially with Chapter 1 and Chapter 2 both being delayed so dramatically, and yes, I know there is COVID, but I feel like they should have plans for next season to have it be a little bit shorter. And I feel like Epic Games doesn't have to go crazy with the amount of new items and locations. Maybe 1 to 2 new locations would be good enough. And then if they change up the mythic locations, hey, that's completely fine as well. If they're gonna take those out of the game, then I would say they have to increase the amount of locations they add. But they could do something similar to what they did this season. They could sort of switch around the locations, like the yacht, it's not a mythic location anymore. I feel like they could do that with this season's mythic POIs, either change them like they did the yacht to non-named locations, or make them into new mythic POIs like they did for multiple different mythic POIs this season. But you guys are gonna have to tell me what you think about the length of these seasons, because at this point it's just a little bit too long for my liking. And you guys are also going to have to tell me whether you like the lack of items and updates this season. Because for me, I love the new items each week. It makes it feel like it's a new game every single week. And I feel like Epic Games has totally strayed away from that for some reason. I understand if it's for competitive purposes. They don't want to add these crazy weird items into competitive, but I know it's been talked about before, but why not have different loot pools for competitive in arena and then have the crazy weird items just in the public matches and maybe LTMs as well. I don't know exactly why Epic Games doesn't do that. That would also help with the sweats in regular lobbies as well. If you want to practice for tournaments, you're gonna have to go into arena because you're not gonna get that realistic loot pool in regular public matches, taking out some of the sweats. I did want to talk about one of the major changes this season, and it's been a problem. I'm probably not going to talk about it in another video, so these videos are perfect for it. I feel like every single new addition to Fortnite isn't new whatsoever. We might get 1 to 2 new items per season, but every other item they add that is new isn't really all that new. Like cars, for example, we waited years and years for cars to come out, and when they finally did, in my opinion, that wasn't that massive of a difference from items we've had in the past. To me, I think cars are a worse version of quad crashers, which absolutely sucks. I think quad crashers are that perfect example of great mobility that's on the ground. I think another great example is ballers as well, because it's creative. I know it's like a hamster ball, but still, it's creative, it's unique. Cars are literally something that should have been added into the game in the beginning, and then they worked off of that. Because I feel like cars are the most basic mobility Epic Games could have added. They're not creative, they're not unique. But quad crashers, for example, give the game such a nice and fresh feel, and the mobility aspect of them, the way you can just fly around the map, is so awesome. But then we get the downgraded version of the cars, which I just really can't stand behind. I don't like the cars. I don't think they're creative. I would rather have so many other mobility than those cars, and I feel like they aren't really a new item in my opinion. And same thing with a lot of items that have been new very recently, whether it be this season or last season or in Chapter 2 Season 1. Everything feels like a reskin of an old item, but worse. I would take Shockwaves over Crash Pad any day of the week, and I feel like Shockwaves are a better version of the Crash Pads. So it's like Epic Games adds in new items, and I gotta say it like that because to me they aren't all that new. They add in new items that are basically a reskin of old items. And I know it's hard to come up with ideas for a $15 billion company. I know it's hard. They don't have much money to go around to hire creative people to come up with creative items, so I don't put any blame on Epic Games themselves. I think as they get more and more money, I definitely think they should add in less and less items that are new. Crash Pads are a worse version of Shockwaves, and you can't convince me otherwise. And I would say this was a major problem as well last season and the season before as well. All the mythic items, except for a very select few like the Shockwave Launcher, are just a reskin of another item. The Shockwave Launcher is one of the only items this season that felt fresh and new, and you can only get it by killing the sweatiest of sweaty players at a POI that's contested by 50 players. For almost all of the mythic items from this season and last season, I mean, they're just reskins, they're more buffed versions of items we've already had in the past. Again, it just shows Epic Games' lack of creativity and uniqueness for items, which in the past it seemed like we would get those every single day. We'd get new fresh items that felt different and unique. But now we don't get any of that, guys, and it's really sad to see, and I do think it is the downfall of Fortnite, and I think it is one of the reasons why Fall Guys is so popular as of right now. Fall Guys feels fresh and it feels new, and Epic Games has definitely lost that touch and charm. You guys are gonna have to tell me what you think about all this, but I would say Epic Games definitely has gone down the wrong path, and I hope that Epic Games can, in the future, start implementing items that we've never seen before and do it a little bit more frequently like they used to. But as you guys know, I am an XP grinder, and I have been for a while now, so I wanted to talk about it this season. One of the most disappointing seasons ever, and I feel like they could do this if they did what I talked about earlier. If they made the seasons just so insanely short, where there were like 50 days, maybe 40 to 50 days, instead of 70 to 100 days, then they could have the XP grind be this short. But if they are going to keep in the very extremely short XP grind, then they can't have these very, very long seasons. So I really hope to see Epic Games implement something next season that we can grind for, even if it is something as simple as a banner. I really don't understand why Epic Games can't implement meant something, regardless of what it is. It doesn't even have to be all that cool, like a banner for the players who want to sit there and grind this game. Because I don't really see the point of grinding a game where there literally is nothing to work towards. So I feel like Epic Games is really shunning everybody except for the competitive players. Even in creative mode, I don't think they have added the charge shotgun. How does that happen? I don't understand that. It feels like Epic Games only wants to cater to the creative players, and we'll talk about that a little bit more. But that's all the skins this season, guys. Or that's all the skins in my account, not just from this season. It's absolutely insane. If I went through and talked about each one of these, or even a select few of them, this video would be hours long. I think this is the best skin from this season. Absolutely love it. Love the edit styles. I just think it's absolutely amazing, guys. You guys are gonna have to tell me what you think about this skin though. Now we're gonna be moving on to the pickaxes. Let's start scrolling through these, guys. Just so many pickaxes. It's absolutely insane. But you guys are gonna have to tell me whether you think you are being shunned by Epic Games. I feel like public match players must feel that effect as well. Everyone but the comp community, the sweatiest of sweaty players, those are the only ones that are being catered to, and they still complain the most out of anybody. So I feel like I'm gonna take my chance to complain a little bit as well. There's no new fun items for those public match players, the ones who don't take this game all that seriously. There isn't that XP grind for the players like me who love to grind XP, who love to play this game for XP and levels. And then even for those creative players, you can't even get the new items into creative to mess around with. The only people who are being catered to are the competitive community, the ones who do complain the most out of anybody. So I do find it odd that Epic Games caters so much to them. I mean, I guess it makes sense. Most of the money in this game goes to the competitive community, but it feels like, why not just add a little something for the XP grinders? It's like, why not just toss us a bone, toss us a skin edit style, toss us something we can work towards. I've said this in the past and I'll say it once more. I just think that Epic Games doesn't really care about having fun in Fortnite anymore. And if you guys are expecting Epic Games to get back to the fun, wacky self that it was in the past that made the game so popular in the first place, that is never going to happen, guys. I feel like Epic Games has strayed away from that completely. And if you're clinging on to hope that Epic Games will bring that back in the future, we'll lose that hope. It's not going to happen. And I know it's hard because in the beginning, this game was so much fun. The wacky items were so crazy. Anything could happen in a game. But as of right now, the sweats dominate this game. So just guys, if you're trying to get back, if you think there's a chance you can get back to the fun, wacky self Fortnite once was, it's not gonna happen. Lose that hope. Trust me. One more thing I did want to talk about, guys, is the amount of items I have. I feel like I have to mention it each time I do one of these videos on my account because I do have so many items. But to be honest, it's just gotten to the point where it's like, if I want to make a video, let's say in 5 seasons from now, and I continue to buy items the way I have been, I am going to have to spend an hour on one of these videos, and I don't think you guys are going to want to see that. That's why I have introduced, you know, me speeding up certain sections of these videos. I feel like in the future, I'm gonna have to speed up the pickaxes, the gliders, and the wraps if I end up showing those. But guys, I can't show off the emotes unless I were to speed it up. There are too many of them, but I guess you guys may be curious what items I buy as of right now. So as of right now, guys, I don't really buy any emotes and I don't buy any gliders, and I buy the very, very select few wraps that I really, really love. The only items that I buy all of are the pickaxes and the skins. Like, this is a new item. I probably wouldn't have purchased it unless I was a collector of these items. But I never really use gliders. I don't really use wraps all that often. I like one, in all honesty. That's all I use. But for pickaxes and skins, I feel like you can see them the whole game. You're always looking at them, and they do add quite a few good ones, I would say. So I do like collecting those. But at this point, I am sort of questioning whether I should even be buying all of the items in this game. Is there really any point to, as of right now? I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I know I've asked this a lot, but do you think I should be buying every single item in this game? same. I definitely haven't been playing Fortnite nearly as much as I used to, and that's just due to the fact that there is nothing to grind in this game, and playing this game just normally without playing in creative or custom lobbies, and even my custom lobbies are full of stream snipers, so those aren't even that much fun. But playing this game like regular public matches or just regular arena mode, it's just not fun, guys. It's not at all. Even if I'm lucky enough to get something like the Caddy Launcher, I die with it instantly because everyone else around me is so good. And that's just the problem, guys. It's just the players are too good in this game. Unless you play 10 hours a day, you're not gonna keep up. All right, guys, that's all the pickaxes. I feel like they changed up this pickaxe so much. What? It wasn't this before. No, it wasn't. All right, guys, let's move on to the gliders. All right, guys, I will be speeding up my gliders because if I went through all of them and actually try to showcase them, it's just a little bit too much. But the only glider I use as of right now is the Sail Shark because I absolutely love gliders you can stand on, and the Sail Shark is my favorite out of all of them. I really hope Epic Games adds more gliders that you can stand on because I absolutely love them, and I feel like the community loves them as well. I think some people may be interested in wondering whether I get any of the exclusive items, and I really can't remember what like the newest exclusive item even is. But at this point, guys, I really don't care to. If it's very, very easy for me to get, then I'll get it. But I'm not gonna go out of my way to buy something for like 500 bucks for a skin. That's just not how I'm going to do it. I'll buy it off of someone for maybe like $30 to $50. But at this point, guys, I feel like Epic Games should just add it to the shop. They should add it to the shop at an insane price, like $30 to $50 for a skin, and give those profits to whatever company they're working for. Yes, they still can promote whatever they're trying to sell, whether that be a phone or a computer, whatever it is, but I feel like they could sell it in the shop, and if you want to go out of your way to buy whatever product they're promoting, feel free and you can still get the skin that way. But that's definitely what I would like to see. I hate going around and trying to like get some scummy, you know, underground deal going to buy a skin on Fortnite. And Epic Games shouldn't pretend like that's how most of those sales actually happen. One more thing I want to mention before we're done with the gliders, is there any hype for this new season coming out in less than a week? I mean, at this point, there's just no hype at all. I don't understand it, guys. I just hope somehow Epic Games can add in something that just draws the attention of all Fortnite players, new and old. We'll see if they're able to do that, guys. I just doubt it. I truly do. I will quickly scroll through my wraps. I'm gonna speed it up yet again, guys. But I gotta say, the wraps are just not my favorite. I feel like at this point, there just aren't any ideas for wraps, guys. The only one I use is the Astro wrap, the Constellations. That's the only one I really care to use, guys. Other than that, I just don't think Epic Games is getting creative enough, or maybe the possibilities just aren't there. Everything feels pretty similar, and I've got to say, I don't really care for too many of them. Well, that's it for my locker, guys. I'm not going to show off all my emotes because I do have so many of them, and it would take forever. But my current level is account level 1,929. I have 580 solo wins with about 12,200 eliminations, 546 duo wins with about 8,300 eliminations, 158 squad wins with about 1,200 eliminations, and 661 LTM wins with 12,700 eliminations. Thank you guys so much for watching another one of my locker videos. I will have one at the end of next season. If you guys could, make sure to use my code COBESMIND in the item shop, guys. It helps me out so much. I hope you guys do have a good one out there. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys later. Bye, guys.